Hey, folks, welcome to Weekend Technical Analysis Update by InTheMoneyStocks.com, your leaders in pure technical analysis, avoiding all that Wall Street hype. This technical analysis video is for Monday, July 23rd through Friday, July 27th, 2012. My name is Gareth Soloway, Chief Market Strategist at InTheMoneyStocks.com. All right, guys, what you're looking at before you is a chart of the SPY, which mirrors the S&P 500. Now, you're looking at it on a 10-minute chart, candlestick chart basis, and ultimately, you're looking at the last 5 days, all of last week. And I want to start with this because I want to talk about how the market reacted, what it did last week, and then we'll project into next week, give you the exact analysis where the market should be headed for the coming week. Number one, you can see we did have a small up week. Really, the first four trading days were neutral to higher. You have basically a neutral day on Monday, a nice little reversal day Tuesday, which led into a rally on Wednesday, a small up day on Thursday, and then you had a bear flag leading into Friday, which played out. And again, really, if you analyze the chart, it was all there for you to see. All right, again, going back to Monday, choppy action, flat day. Then you had this gap up and collapse. But then the markets showed massive strength rallying back, and that's what led into the rally. Whenever you see this V-shape, V-shapes are very, very powerful, assuming it holds the upside of the V towards the end of the day. So downward move, which was very bearish, but then the fact that the bulls could fight back and rally the market back to its highs, that was significant. That led us into the rally on Wednesday, and then you started to run into resistance. You hit this pivot top right up here at the 138.20 level. And notice you had a little bit of an in spirit of head and shoulders pattern. Let me zoom in on that Thursday pattern. All right, so here's your shoulder, here's your head and shoulder. All right, let me just go over that again, folks. I'll draw it in so all of you guys can really make sure to see. And when you analyze this kind of thing, you need to understand that the charts are basically speaking to you. They are telling you where the next day is going. All right, every day in the market will dictate where the next day goes, either by the 10-minute chart patterns for the early move on the next day or on the daily chart, which tells you the next few days. So here you have a clear head and shoulders. Draw your neckline in. So there it is, shoulder, head, shoulder. In addition, this down move and these inside bars staying below the slanted line was a very direct signal that the markets were going to have a little bit of a sell-off on Friday. Sure enough, Friday you gap down. You have a nice sideways action packed here, which again, off the down move, is an in spirit of bearish pattern. You sell off into the 200, and then you have another in spirit of pattern that doesn't have time to play out, but may play out on Monday. Now, what I want to make clear here, folks, is you're in this kind of gray area coming into this coming week, and I'm going to be very explicitly clear so you guys understand exactly what I'm saying. All right, the market is going to start to tank very soon, and it's going to be a large sell-off. All right, you saw some of the worries developing on Friday with the yields in Spain jumping on the 10-year to all-time highs. That is obviously a negative, a big negative, and the markets reacted to the downside as the dollar got a bid. The key is, do we have a little bit of upside early in the week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, before the big selling starts, or does it just begin, or has it already begun essentially on Friday? And I want to show you the reasoning behind this. Number one, if we go to the daily chart here, all right, obviously you had a beautiful double top right there. All right, now, the one case for possible upside still is the fact that you haven't achieved this level up here. This is the master level. This is the max move level. All right, and again, these are all keys. And by the way, we explain how to do all this stuff in the Research Center, which is part of the In the Money Stock Services. Research Center is for swing traders and investors. Day traders, the intraday stock chat, is where we go over live trading and all that kind of stuff and give you trades and analyze the markets all day long. Both have 7-day free trials, folks. So again, you can try us out for 7 days. Ultimately, people end up staying for years and just become some of the best traders in the world. We've trained some of the best traders, swing traders in the world, people that had no clue. Trust me when I say no clue. They came to us with no clue. They are still with us because they love us, but now they're making tons of money. And again, it started with a free trial. That's all it was. Beautiful stuff. In any case, so again, you double topped here, which was the first little bearish signal, and you pull back off of that. We'll know Monday. If Monday breaks this lower blue trend line, this sell-off's on. It's on like Donkey Kong, as they say. All right, so this line, see the sloping line? That's what you're watching. That's a bearish pattern off of this move down here. So it's ultimately just a matter of time. Personally, I wouldn't mind to see one more push up getting in this range because then you really get a great entry on shorts. I've already accumulated some shorts based on PPT methodology, which is price pattern and time methodology. But ultimately, I have the exposure to the short side. I wouldn't mind having a little bit more if we go up here. If not, then I'm still making money on the drop, which is the beauty of what we do here at In the Money Stocks. We position ourselves just to make money no matter what in a long or short market. Doesn't matter. All right, but bottom line is, again, folks, we should know Monday, Tuesday, whether or not you break this line here or if you break this. I mean, see how close they are? So basically, this blue line's right here around the 135 and a quarter level, which is only a buck 25 lower on the spiders. Or if you can get above this blue line, then it's telling you you're going to this level right up here. All right, so again, it's just a matter of, in the Monday, Tuesday session, which way do we go here? All right, and we'll know, obviously, based on Monday's action on a closing basis. It's always on a closing basis, too, guys. Remember that. All right, in any case, so volume on Monday could be a little bit light unless Europe continues to freak out. If the Spanish yields continue to soar, markets will freak out here. We'll be watching very closely there. A couple keys that I think are very negative for this market that are telling us that we're very, very close to this big sell-off. Look at Goldman's chart. All right, draw a trend line here connecting the lows. All right, take that low and just connect it through. So not only did you sell off this week and get below both these moving averages, but if you connect these lows, you've now closed below that trend line. That's a bearish sign for the markets. JP Morgan, same thing. I mean, this stock had this great pop on earnings announcements about a week ago, and then all last week it sold off, even when the market was rallying up. Remember, the first two-thirds of the week or so, we rallied higher. And then JPM just sold straight off. And if you connect these low pivots, look at that. So you hit there, you hit there, you hit there, you hit there, and then you broke on Friday. So those are some very worrisome signals. Ultimately, guys, there's no doubt in my mind that this market is going lower, and it's going to be a pretty decent sell-off. The question is, can we get one more little pop in the market before the big selling comes in? All right, that's the big question. And it's really semantics at this point. I mean, it's so minor. You know, you ultimately maybe get a buck or two move up on the spiders, and that's it, and then you drop out, or you just drop straight out. And based on the JPM chart, it wouldn't be surprised if we go straight down. But I'm still, again, that's how I position myself with my members here at InMoneyStocks.com. Whether you're a chat room trader or a swing trade trader, which is in the research center here, which again, as I said, both offer 7-day free trials. You have your shorts that we already accumulated for this move, that were a majority of them were pretty much in the money on. But the beauty of it is, they'll all work out because the markets are going to tank. And in an ideal scenario, as I said, maybe we'll get a small move up Monday, Tuesday before the flush. I don't know if that's going to happen, though. I mean, we're borderline. It's borderline Armageddon to the point of, my guess is we have a 5 to 10% move down coming in this market in the next 2 months. Maybe even less. Maybe even less. All right? So that's what we have going on there, folks. Good stuff. I love this excitement because as a day trader, I'm a day trader and a swing trader. I do both. So I love the volatility, I love the whipsaw action on an intraday basis, and then I love being able to swing and analyze the charts on a daily basis because then I'm making money intraday and I'm making money on my swing trades. It's the best of both worlds. For those of you that work 9 to 5, you just focus on the swing side. If you're a day trader, you can focus on both. But the swing side is beautiful too because we can see ahead of time, just like analyzing these charts, where this market is going to go. All right, let's take a look at a couple other charts. We've looked at the financials, which obviously that was a warning signal all last week. When the financials couldn't get a bid, got to be alert on that. All right. In addition, let's take a look at a couple other stocks. How's Apple's chart looking here? Yeah, I mean, to be honest, Apple's chart is micro bearish, but there's not much you can do here. And again, earnings on this week are coming out on Apple, so just be aware of that too, guys. That Tuesday earnings from Amazon, which is an interesting chart I want to cover in a second, but Apple's earnings are on Thursday, I believe. So, you know, the tricky thing is you have a small micro bearish pattern here, but look at the moving average support right below. So there's not much ability to go short here. And at the same time, I mean, the stock, you can't go long into earnings. You know, it could easily, I mean, it could pop up into double top here, but at the same time, it could flush 50 bucks too. You know, I mean, look at what happened to Chipotle on Friday. And that's just a great example. CMG just got absolutely annihilated. $86.88 drop on CMP, Chipotle Mexican Grill, and you know, just an absolute ugly flush. But I'll tell you one thing, CMG, this is the best support level. If you can get this down here, CMG becomes very intriguing to me as a swing trade. See this pivot low with this pivot low? So you really need it to drop all the way down into the, I guess that's around the 270 level, 270, 265. It becomes a very attractive swing trade. It's the lower band of this movement here, which always ends up being the most support if it can get there. And that's where you would get a bounce, a very big bounce at that. You'd probably get a bounce back to 300 on that if you could get it at 270, 265. All right, let's go to the Amazon chart. As I said, I wanted to discuss that chart, guys. And What I love about the Amazon chart, it's a scene of the crime play, which is a methodology point here. So you have a trend line right here, which connects through all the lows, right? So you connect through this one after starting it down here to this, to this, to this, and you finally break down. Now you've bounced all the way back here. Methodology dictates that you have a decent chance for a small pullback off of that. Although, again, a warning, earnings are coming up. And by the way, no smart investor or trader plays earnings. Why? Because ultimately, you cannot guarantee yourself with an 80 to 90% success rate which way the move on earnings will go, unless you have inside information, in which case you're breaking the law anyways. But the point is, as a trader, and this is so important, mark my words here, as an investor or a trader, I only take trades that I have an 80% chance to 90% chance of winning. Now, you'll never get 100%, so that's just mark that out of the book. Again, unless you have inside information, but 80 to 90% is your goal. That means 8 out of every 10, 9 out of every 10 charts, you should be winning, trades you should be winning. When at the average amateurs out there trade, they love to play earnings because they say, oh, I can make $1 million. Well, yeah, but you can lose $1 million too, and it's a 50-50. Or maybe at best 60-40 if you read the chart correctly. But smart traders don't play earnings because it's a crapshoot. Might as well go to the casino, as I always tell my traders, and get some free drinks and look at some, attractive people and dealers and all those, have some fun that way. At least if you're getting 50-50 odds at the blackjack table or a little less than 50-50, but at least you're getting enjoyment out of it. Trading is a business. Swing trading is a business. You're trying to accumulate wealth here. All right, when you go to the casino, you're not thinking that you're really going to win big. I mean, no one, if you do, then you're kind of loopy, in my opinion. You're going there to have fun. Trading, make money. Profit. Day after day, profit. Swing trade, week after week, profit. You're trying to build millions of dollars in an account, billions of dollars. Right? You do it right, you have to analyze the charts using the PPT methodology. PPT, not plunge protection team, but it's just as good. Price, pattern, and time methodology, which is exactly what we preach here. We will teach you it. We will give it to you. We'll rock your world with it, folks. Bottom line is, based on this, you might see a pullback early in the week before earnings, maybe on Monday, a little bit of a small pullback on Amazon. You also have double top resistance right up here as well, which is kind of interesting on that chart. All right, let's get to another couple charts here. Research in Motion was down another 19 cents. Honestly, I'm not looking at that until it gets down to about $5. $5, it becomes an option play. I'd consider tucking away a little bit in a swing trade account at $5 or so, just as an option play. Maybe they get bought out for 7, 8, 9, $10, or you have to face the facts that maybe it goes under. Who knows? I don't think it'll go under because they have too many patents out there, so there's some value to it. But at least at $5, it becomes attractive. It still needs to drop about $1.50, $1.75, in my opinion, to become interesting. What else? Google had a good move on earnings on Friday. Interesting chart here as it popped up. I'll tell you this though. Look at this, guys. Look at that. Now, would anyone have thought that you could predict a high of Google on earnings? Nope, probably not, unless you know the methodology here at TheMoneyStocks.com and you know trend line analysis. Look at that. Connect all the highs. Perfect. To the penny, like literally to the penny. The beauty of this is, technically speaking, if you knew that, you could have shorted it. Right at that exact top. Now you go tell your buddies and your friends, oh, by the way, I shorted Google on Friday and made money. They'd look at you like you had three heads. But to be honest, you could have. All right, where was the top? Let's go to the intraday chart on Google here and see exactly what it is. All right. So basically, you would have known at this high. And look at that pullback. And it even floated up. So, I mean, you basically would have got the exact high of, let's say, 612.75. And it pulled all the way back down to 607. I mean, that's a $5 gain on a little quick short over the course of an hour, 2 hours. Awesome trade right there. Awesome trade. All right, so again, it's all about just seeing the charts, knowing your analysis. And by the way, there's a decent chance that eventually Google breaks out from this based on certain methodology points that we know. But you would wait for consolidation first and a pullback before that happens and look for that at a later point. All right. Other than that, folks, I think that's about it. Exxon and Chevron. Chevron was actually up on Friday. Exxon was down. UNG continues to ramp up. I think UNG is probably going to this 200, though it's too extended to be a buy at this point, but it would be a short at the 200 if it gets there. Oil looks like it's pulling back a little bit. Good pullback on Friday off of this little pivot high. See this little pivot high right there? And by the way, guess where I shorted it with my members at InTheMoneyStocks.com? Right at that pivot high. And we're already in the money nicely. Go tell some people that you're short oil and you're in the money already. They're not going to believe you either. And sure enough, we are here at In the Money Stocks. Bottom line is, the methodology works. Plain and simple. Take the 7-day free trial. Again, swing traders and investors, that's the Research Center. Go to inthemoneystocks.com, take the Research Center free trial. If you're a day trader, if you want intraday action, take the intraday stock chat. And by the way, the Research Center has videos, live broadcasts with charts. It has swing trade alerts. I mean, you get it all in the Research Center. So rock it, make some money. This is the time to do it, folks. Markets are going to get some pretty crazy action in the coming weeks. It's there for the taking. Profits are definitely there for the taking. All right, take care, guys. Again, come join us here at InTheMoneyStocks.com.